In this video, I want to talk about adding an automatic zip code lookup capability into your CRM or contact database. Now, the reason, of course, I would find this interesting is that we have FM Starting Point, which is, of course, a very free, popular CRM for the FileMaker platform. So the other day, someone was showing me a demo of this free service called Zippopotamas. Now, Zippopotamas is an interesting take on the word zip and hippopotamus, and you come up with a clever name for a startup company. What we actually have is a demo file in FileMaker that talks to this online service to actually look up the city and the state based upon a zip code that you put into it. It's pretty cool. Now, Zippopotamas works with all sorts of countries worldwide. In fact, they have a countries list right here. Now, the rub with the way Zippopotamas works is that you actually have to put the country into the country field before you put the zip code in, before it'll work. Now, of course, that was kind of a hassle. So for the United States and Canadian users, we've actually preset up our demo file over here to know whether you're actually looking at a US or Canadian zip code. So it actually pre-populates the country, either US or CA for Canada, and that way we pass that to Zippopotamas with the zip code during the transaction. So real simple, this is a 3-record database. It doesn't really matter what it is. It can be a 1-record. I can just make it 1-record right here. Let's change this to 95945 and say look up. And that's Grass Valley, California, one of the places where I grew up in my youth many years ago. And of course, this Grass Valley information here was not actually in the database. This request went out using a script here that we're going to show you, out to the free Zippopotamas server, did a quick lookup, and brought the information back. Now, I can show you how this works real quick. There's actually only 2 scripts in here of any relevancy. There's only really 1 field that you have to define. You have this global text field right here that you have to define. And these are pretty simple fields right here. And you call this script right here. And this script right here basically says, oh, don't forget, you're gonna have to send us script parameters, which are a return delimited set of parameters. Pretty straightforward. And then it runs this script right here. Now, we put some additional code in here up front to determine if we had a Canadian or US zip code. And in that way, we could jump ahead without entering the country. Now, if you want this to work in the United Kingdom, or in France, or in South America somewhere, you're gonna play with these scripts a little bit or make sure that you input the country code in advance. But the point of this video is to expose you to this and show you a working demo and maybe get you going and adding this to your own database. It's pretty cool. Now the bottom line is that this whole system uses the insert from URL. We've used insert from URL to talk to a lot of third-party services. And what happens is that Zippopotamas sends back that data to our global text field and it loads it into here. Of course, once it's in here, we parse it apart using some other scripts. Now we have a number of training videos that talk about parsing scripts apart and other topics like that. So if you're interested in learning about that, feel free to get into our FileMaker Pro training series and learn some additional things under the hood that'll make you a much better developer or power user. So that being said, we decided to wire this into FM Starting Point. Now, one of the concerns I have about a service like this is that the service is effectively free. Zippopotamas is a open source, kind of a volunteer effort, it would seem like. It's not really clear on who runs it or what they're doing. It says it's under new management, and of course we can click that and read about the new management, etc. like that. They've been relaunched and they're getting a stable server, and thanks to Samir and Jeff, whoever those people are. Well, thanks to Jeff and Samir, we really appreciate it. The question is that if it's not being paid for or funded, then how reliable is it gonna be? Well, a lot of people use this and it seems to be fairly stable and reliable. But I always have in the back of my mind one of those concepts that you get what you pay for in most cases. And that, of course, works with a lot of things, especially ongoing services. Now, if you download something like FM Starting Point that's free, well, it's a one-time thing. And there's, of course, no guarantees that you'll get new free feature updates. Now, we have been supporting FM Starting Point for like 4 years, and it's been a great success for us, so we plan on doing that. But in the back of my mind, I always understand that these people are not charging for this, and I make my money another way. But these people, I'm not sure how they make their money. It makes me concerned that the service might not be there someday. So what we did is when we built it in FM Starting Point down here in Preferences, this is a new version that'll be coming out shortly, if it's not already out by the time you watch this video, is that we have this option right here, which is use Zippopotamas, yes or no. When we ship it, by default, it's gonna be set to no, okay? Now, why is this a concern? Well, if for some reason the Zippopotamas service becomes unavailable, you're gonna run into a situation where you're gonna type the zip code and FileMaker will tend to just hang and spin, and you'll get this spinning beach ball or dialogue while FileMaker attempts over the course of a minute or two to talk to Zippopotamas. We cannot easily set that timeout. So in an ideal situation, you'd give Zippopotamas 5 seconds to respond. If it didn't respond, you just continue on and the person would have to input the city and state on their own. But FileMaker doesn't give us those kinds of controls, at least not yet. So what we've done is we put a preference setting in here where you can just turn the thing on and off. It ships this default configuration with the no setting, which is off. If you want it turned on, you can click this right here and then go back to contacts. And as you type in a zip code, you're going to get the functionality to work. Now, as I clicked that and I clicked out, there was a slight delay. Well, what the system is doing, it has two things enabled. The mapping system is enabled, which causes FileMaker to look up the Latin long coordinates at the time you exit the zip code. It also ran the Zippopotamas code. So just keep that in mind. If you want more information about these kinds of things or managing FM Starting Point, then I recommend you check out our FileMaker Pro training course at learningfilemaker.com. It's really great. And if you want to play with FM Starting Point, of course you can download a free copy anytime at fmstartingpoint.com.